Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Today we're going to create a purchase order in the QuickBooks Online Plus Plan. If you're wanting to know what features are available in which plan, click the link below. There's a little table will pop up with all of the check marks for which things work in which plans, and purchase orders are only available in the Plus Plan. So let's dive into the sample company and create a purchase order. So to create purchase orders in your business, you need to turn on the feature. We'll pop up here, Account and Settings, Expenses, Purchase Orders. Here we go. And we can turn it on. We have the option for custom fields on our purchase orders as well. This came up earlier. There's a different video that I did for invoices with custom fields. So look at that if you're interested in exploring this more. And then you can put a default message on your purchase orders. And this is a fantastic time saver. Don't be concerned. Anything you put here can be edited. Let's write that. Yeah, it's a useful field. How's this? So if there's something you would particularly like to write on each of your purchase orders, save it here, and then you have the option to edit it when you come to use it. So now we're done. Let's create a purchase order. Under Vendors, we have Purchase Order. So enter the vendor that you're going to be purchasing the items from. Let's purchase from Tanya's Nursery. Then choose, oh look at this, it's pre-filled from a previous video I did where I created some quartz fountains. So yes, let's create another purchase order from Tanya, but let's say that we're going to get 10 this time, 10 of these quartz fountains. Now here you can see our message, look at this. Easily we can edit this. What could we want to, please send by FedEx. Whatever you'd like to write in here, you can write. That's a message that Tanya will receive when she gets her purchase order. Now, if you want, you can tag the customer that this is intended to go to. We sent them to Amy last time. Perhaps she loved them. Maybe we'll put one to Amy, and then we'll have 10 of them, another 9 that won't be related to Amy. So this way we can kind of keep track of what's going on. It's still going to go into our inventory, but it's a nice feature for helping you to allocate things out later and keep track. Sometimes I think the more information, the more options you have to run your reports. So we're going to save and send, but of course we're not sending in the sample company, so we'll save and close. So now let's run a report that shows us all of our open purchase orders. This will show us what we're waiting to receive from our different vendors. Here it is. And from Tanya, we have one item here. This isn't so useful. This is the summary. Why don't we get the open purchase orders now that is in detail? Here we go. The open purchase order detail. This is a little more useful. You can see from Tanya, we're waiting for the 10 fountains. I don't know what happened to the one we had earlier from John that showed up, but anyway, this is what we're waiting to receive from Tanya. So when you do receive the goods from your vendor, you can add them to a bill from the purchase order. So if we pop up here and we find our recent purchase order from Tanya, we can copy this to a bill. So we've got our 10 fountains, we've opened the box, they're beautiful, nothing's broken, everything's fantastic. We've just created a bill. And as you can see, the customer information has copied through too. Now, if we wanted to mark this as billable, which is a feature that's only available in the Plus plan, when we go to create an invoice for Amy, this will flow through. And I've done another separate video on tagging items as billable. So look for that if that's something that interests you. So now let's save and close that. And we've now used the purchase order feature to order 10 fountains from Tanya.
So be sure to click the link below to access the blog post that walks through all of the different features that are available in each of the plans. Click like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you soon. Cheers.